Hello and welcome to the Penguin Prof Channel. My name is Valerie Pennington. I'm a biology professor at Southwestern College. I have not yet made a video since the COVID-19 pandemic began, mainly because I have been recovering from surgery. Actually, I had surgery last month. I'm fine. It was planned. Everything is great. But the other reason why I haven't made any videos is because I'm not an epidemiologist or a virologist or a researcher, and I really didn't feel like I had much to add to the conversation, but according to you guys, that was incorrect. I've been getting a lot of requests for videos. So what I want to do today is really sort of summarize the three categories of requests that I've been getting, and I'm asking for your input. Please tell me how I can help during this time, which is unprecedented in our lifetime. Number one, information videos. Obviously, that's what I do normally on this channel, so that's a no-brainer. So yes, especially videos having to do with immunology, like immunology basics. The second category has to do with what can we do? Like, what should we be doing now? I can address that. And the third category is, how are we going to live like this? So what I want to do in this video is give you a little taste of each of those three things and then ask for your input in terms of what you guys want to see. Okay, category number one, information. I know a lot of you are doing all of your coursework now online, and so the demand for videos and tutorials has never been higher. So I am sort of ranking topics in order of your requests, but of course the number one request has to do with immunology. In fact, today I just want to talk about one thing because I get this question all the time. What does it mean when we say flatten the curve? Flattening the curve means if you plot the number of cases over time, if you look at what happens when we don't act, when there's no mitigation, no social distancing, no testing, no tracking, no nothing, we get this exponential growth curve in terms of the number of cases that occur in a very short period of time. That is bad because the healthcare system, no healthcare system can manage that, right? Because what you've got to remember is approximately 20% of those infected are going to need medical care. Some of them critical care, okay? And no healthcare system is built for these kind of numbers that we're seeing. When we say flatten the curve, we mean the number of cases doesn't change, okay? And that number won't change until we get a vaccine or we start to see herd immunity. I can talk about that in another video if you'd like. When you squash that curve, it means that the number of cases just gets spread out over time. Okay, so it is really important to flatten the curve so that the number of cases never rises above the maximum capacity of the healthcare system. General request number two, how can I help? First of all, I want to say so many of you watching this video right now are first responders or medical healthcare workers, and to you, I say thank you so much for what you are doing right now. Words cannot express the debt of gratitude that we owe you. But for those of us who are not actually out on the front lines, a big question I get is, what can we do? Okay, really quick. Number one thing is to follow the advice of healthcare providers. So stay informed. Believe it or not, as most of you know, the most important thing right now is for people to stay home. Go out only when necessary to get basic necessities. Dr. Emily Landon, who is the lead epidemiologist at Chicago Medical, said, "It is really hard to feel like you're saving the world when you're watching Netflix from your couch, but if we do this right, nothing happens." And I really want to emphasize that. Nothing happens if we get this right. So a lot of people at the end of all of these, you know, shelter in place orders, they're going to say, "See, nothing happened. All of that was wasted." And that's not true. Nothing happening is what we are going for here, okay? Because what we are trying to do is flatten the curve and prevent that catastrophe of healthcare systems being overwhelmed, which is what we're seeing in Italy right now. Another thing you can do is make sure you check in on family members and neighbors who may need help who cannot leave the house for whatever reason because of their conditions. So make sure you check in on seniors. Also, you want to check in with children and teens and talk to them about what's going on. They may be having a lot of anxiety that they don't know how to express. Another group of people we're very worried about are people who were already dealing with physical or mental challenges, people dealing with substance abuse. These kinds of situations can really exacerbate a lot of pre-existing conditions. So if you know people like this, please reach out to them. Having said that, if you need help, I am going to put a list of resources in the description box below. And if you can help by providing resources that are not yet listed, please let me know and I will share those as well. Category three, people want to know, how do I live like this? And I'll just give you a handful of suggestions. Again, these are things that I can make videos about as well. Number one, set up routines. So you have a specific routine for work or study time, house chores, time outside, play time, social time, etc. My second suggestion is going to be to limit news and social media. It's really important to be informed, but you don't need it 24/7. Okay, some people are just watching the news constantly and that will make you crazy. So limit your exposure. Something that will help a lot is getting outside, getting some exercise, getting some fresh air. I live in San Diego, so I went for a walk yesterday fairly close by, and I can share that as well if you just need to see something beautiful. By the way, I'm trying to post beautiful things from past travels on Instagram every day. A lot of us are sort of traveling virtually, so if you think that could help, I can do that as well. Surround yourself with positive people, positive energy. Maybe you just need to see more of Flops. I can do that. Okay, so those are the three categories as I see them of things that I can do. Like you, I'm trying to find out what I can do to try and improve our condition during these very challenging times. Please let me know in the comments below. Message me on social media. I wish all of you nothing but safety and peace. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.